experience of our experience in the CE research or capillary tuberculosis research, sharing on this publication. My research group, Special Science and Technology Group, STEPSTECH, led by Professor Dr. Wan Iman Ibrahim. And then, inshallah, as mentioned by Dr. Nurazia, maybe this last month, so my maybe this is my farewell lecture for today. Okay, this is my outline for presentation. Firstly, about the introduction on CE, and then the application of CE and other modes, results and discussion in the fabrication and placement. First, about capillary tuberculosis. This so this instrument CE instrument. CE is one of the special methods suitable for routine application. Okay, this
this.
Okay, thank you. One of the special methods for routine application, and there are some advantages of CE method. For example, high efficiency, fast analysis, inexpensive, and use minimal organic solvent, and then minimal waste generated. So we can assume this environmental friendly. Okay, this CE system. So it contains some equipment. We can see in this figure there are two buffer reservoirs, yeah, and then very small diameter capillary tube, high voltage power supply, and then also detection system, absorber, protective, and so on. So for example, I bring the CE capillary column. Maybe you can see. This is the only 50 to 10 micrometer for ID and 360 micrometer for OD. Yeah. So there are some injection or protection sample. First one, gravity injection. So this is different in high process sample to flow into capillary. So this capillary, okay, you can see the slide. So this, we can imagine this, the inlet and outlet capillary. This one, the inlet and outlet capillary. And then the second one, the other injection mode is the pressure injection using vacuum and pressure. And then the last one, it is by electrokinetic injection, the most popular injection mode using voltage. Yeah. Using the high voltage supply about 5 kilovolt and so on. Okay, next, maybe we can keep. So this some CE modes, yeah. For example, zone electroporesis or CZE, and then isoelectroporesis, and then isotopoporesis, and then electrokinetic chromatography. There are some type of the EKC. First one is MEKC, micellar electrokinetic chromatography, or also called MECC, micellar electrokinetic capillary chromatography, because we use the capillary column. And then the second one is the microemulsion electrokinetic chromatography. So different micellar and the microemulsion in this EKC mode. So this about the efficacy. MEKC was first introduced by Prof. Terabe from Japan in 1984. I have met him in 2011 in Kyoto, Japan. And then this technique is a powerful technique to solve many chemical analysis problem using C instrument without any alteration. And then the expression principle of analytics is based on their differential partitioning between micellar base and aqueous base in the BCG, background electrolyte. And then this is the MEKC, microemulsion electrochemical chromatography. Using an aqueous buffer containing droplet of oil, surfactant, and co-surfactant to form a microemulsion BCG, background electrolyte solution. Microemulsion solution use water immiscible solvent, oil, such as an heptane or an octane, and a surfactant such as SDS, sodium reticulate sulfate, in a case buffer like borate or phosphate. Co-surfactant such as butanoanol is often added to improve the microemulsion stability. So this expression in MEKC, expression based on its heterogeneities and electrophoretic mobilities. High pH buffer function in the microemulsion is to generate a high TOF, electroosmotic flow, when the voltage apply across the capillary filled with the buffer solution. Surfactant coated oil droplets are negatively charged and therefore attempt to migrate towards to the anode when the voltage is applied. So this some CE potential application such as agrochemicals, pharmaceuticals, cosmetics, food industry, health and medical, forensic and so on. So this I would like to share about the some application of MEKC and MEKC in this seminar. First one, application of MEKC. Application of MEKC method for chirospiration of selected pesticides or triazole fungicides in this case. First one, the optimization of MEKC method for chirospiration of selected triazole fungicide, and then online preconcentration and chirospiration of triazole fungicide by CD MEKC to enhance the sensitivity. And the second one, the application of MEKC method for the estimation of log POW, octanol water partition coefficient, values of selected triazole fungicides. So we have studied the influence of surfactant types on the correlation of log K, reduction factor in MEKC and heterotopicity. Then rapid estimation of log POW values of triazole fungicide compounds by MEKC using sodium deoxycholate, SDC, as surfactant. That is the second one, is the application of MEKC. Application of MEKC method for the analysis of pharmaceutical cream sample. We get the determination of the meconazole as azole drugs by the optimized SPE MEKC method, solid phase extraction and MEKC method. And then also the application of MEKC method for the analysis of NSA, non-steroidal and anti-inflammatory drugs. Well, this ongoing research mission of MEKC method for selected preparation and then determination of selected NSA by the optimized SPMTE MEKC method, solid phase membrane thin extraction MEKC method. It is would like to share about the result from the non-expression of triazole fungicide by CD MEKC. So this type of the MEKC using the cycloxin as additive. What is the enantiomers? Enantiomers is two non superimposable structures that are mirror images of each other. It has the identical in chemical properties and identical in physical properties. Except in their activity toward optically active regions. And then, except for the direction in which they rotate the plane of polarized light. So, building activity for each enantiomer is different from each other. Then to determine the quantity of each enantiomer, we expression of this required. So this is the importance of enantiomer expression. Okay, this one, enantiomers are chirality, vitally important in the chemical, pharmaceutical, and agricultural industries, and then produce critically different pharmacological political system. They fled the non-territoriality of chiral compounds and political determination, and then for the isolation of pure non-tioma in drug industry. Since the inclusion about the target fungicide, the target analysis for this study, target fungicide is one of the most important categories of fungicides. It has excellent protective, curative, and radical power against a wide spectrum of crop disease. And then, the chirality is expected to play a crucial role in bioactivities of triazole fungicides. This some chemical structure of the selected triazole fungicides. For example, the propiconazole, it has two chiral center. The tibuconazole has one chiral center, and then the fenconazole also has one chiral center. So this is the chemical structure of propiconazole nantiomers. It has two chiral center, and then it has two pairs of nantiomer or four stereoisomers. So the 2R and 4S propiconazole, 2S and 4R, and then 2R and 4R, and then 2S and 4S propiconazole. So we can spare this nantiomers. So this comparison between the conventional chromatochromic techniques and then the MEKC or CE techniques on the chiral expression. Firstly, using GC or SPLC as methods. This method using the microliter sample follow and then CE on the nanoliter sample follow. And then second one is the time consuming, and then CE is short of this time. You can see the result. And then GC or SPLC requires expensive chiral volume, about 9,000 ringgit per volume. Compared with the CE, this one, we get the CE volume about 500, I think 500 ringgit per 20 meter. So more cheaper. Then minimal use of chiral selector. GC or SPLC use large amount of organic sulfur, and CE little use of hazardous organic sulfurs or environmentally friendly. So this two type of the non-telomere expression by MKC. Firstly, using Bell's chiral surfactants, for example the SDC, and then Hollet, and then Bell's as chiral surfactant. And then the second one is using CD or cyclodextrin as chiral selector, or we call the method is the CD MKC. That is result from the chiral expression of the propiconazole. The first one, we studied the efficacy with Biolsat as chiral surfactant, so we only get the two propiconazole beads, so not complete expression. And then using the CD efficacy with HP gamma CD as chiral selector, we get the four fix of propiconazole nantiomers. Speaking of the study, Penmetsa in 1997 used CDMKC for non-tiomeric and isomeric expression of several pesticides, including propiconazole, but only two isomers of propiconazole peaks were observed. This peak from the Penmetsa studies. Yeah. Okay, and then using the HPLC column, this column. Yeah. Evidence of propiconazole expression using a space on F01 hollow, where these technologies are also only 3 peaks observed from this study. So this our finding the non-tiomeric expression of propiconazole by the optimized CDMKC method. So all stereoisomers of propiconazole were spread 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, using the expression solution 30 millimolar HP gamma CD and mixed with 50 millimolar SDS using the organic modifier methanol and sulfitryl in 25 millimolar phosphate buffer BH7 and voltage 30 kilovolt and temperature 20 degrees Celsius. So this other algo program from the online CDMKC methods under natural condition or Beckett 7 is a big normal CDMKC using sample injection 1 second at 50 millibar. This algo program B is the normal stacking mode or NSM, the online preconcentration technique. CDMKC, sample injection 15 seconds at 50 millibar. And then the last one, C, is the sweeping CDMKC, the other online preconcentration technique in CE, using sample injection 90 seconds at 50 millibar. So different in injection time, yeah? 1 second, 15 seconds, and 90 seconds. The similar condition of the CE. So this result from the linearity, repeatability, LOD, and sensitivity induction factor (SEF) for conventional enantiomer in the optimized CDMKC and online CDMKC methods under natural condition or BN7. So as you can see in this table, for the SEF LOD for the normal stacking mode, 5 times, and then for the sweeping is 25. So better you use the sweeping for the online preconcentration technique. So we continue to study the sweeping CDMKC at acidic condition using the BH3 as the optimized BH. Then we apply to the simultaneous chiral expression of 3 chiral fungicides, propiconazole, dipiconazole, and fenconazole, and we apply the SPE sweeping CDMKC at BH3 acidic condition to application to grape samples. So this result, the electrogram of the selected chiral tetrahydral fungicide by CDMKC at acidic pH. So this F is the fenconazole, T, dipiconazole. We can see this two peaks, yeah, because F and T contain one chiral center, and P is propiconazole. So this A, fenconazole, dipiconazole, and propiconazole sample in specific solution treated 1 second at 50 millibar. So the normal CDMKC. And then this one, the fenconazole, dipiconazole, and propiconazole using the sweeping CDMKC treated for 120 seconds at 50 millibar. So this result, linearity, repeatability, SEF, and LOD of the optimized sweeping CDMKC method under the acidic condition. So, as can be seen in this table, for the fenconazole, LOD is 30 mg per liter. Then the SEF, LOD is 0.09 ppm, and then dipiconazole, SEF is 70, and LOD is 0.1, and then propiconazole, SEF is 100 and LOD is 0.1. So this algorithm of the non-term expression of the tetrahydral fungicide spike in grape sample after preconcentration by SPE sweeping CDMKC. So unknown peaks from the sample matrix. It is the peak from the fenconazole, this one is dipiconazole, and this one from propiconazole. With the average recovery about 109, 73 and 74. So I continue to other application of MKC in rapid estimation of octanol water partition coefficient or log P of tetrahydral fungicide by MKC. It's the introduction. Yeah, determination of log P. There are two methods, direct and indirect methods. For the direct method, using sec flash method. So this some difficulties of the sec flash method: long analysis time, requires pure compounds, and then difficulty in temperature control. Well, the indirect method, for example, reverse phase SPLC and MKC methods. The some advantages of this indirect method is rapid analysis, automation, and then smaller sample increment than temperature control. So the background of the study, Hebert Dorsey in 1995 reported the correlation of MKC representation data log K to log P OW was phone high for over 100 solids with widely varying functionality. Young et al. In 1997 reported that Bellsouth's micellar system provide the better correlation for log K retention factor versus log POW than SDS micellar system. The first SDLC method was applied to estimate log POW for some trousal fungicides, including perpenazole and triadimenol. With log POW inference was found to be 0.28 and 0.46 respectively. There is no efficacy study being reported on the correlation between log K versus log POW for trousal fungicide and rapid estimation of log POW for trousal fungicide compounds by MEKC. So we try to use the MEKC for this study. This structure of trousal fungicide used in the study, 9 compounds. So this data, the log POW values of the 5 trousal fungicide standards. So we use the cyclopentanazole, bromoconazole, epoxiconazole, ketotonol, and difenoconazole as the standard. That's the data. Then we try to the influence of surfactant types and concentration on the correlation of log K in MEKC and log POW of 5 trousal fungicide standards using the SDS as surfactant and then Bellsouth as surfactants. Sodium folate, sodium deoxyfolate, and then mix SC and SDC. So using the SDS surfactant, suppression was not successfully achieved. And using a Bellsouth suppression of trousal was successfully achieved. And then rapid estimation of log POW values of 4 test compounds by MEKC using SDC as surfactant. So this program of trousal fungicide with different SDS concentration. So as we can see in this figure, using the 30 millimolar, 40 millimolar, and 50 millimolar SDS, suppression is not complete. And then using the SC, sodium folate as surfactant. So we can see in this electro program, we get the suppression from the 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 4, 5, 6 compounds. 6 is the micelle marker, phenanthrene. So this electro program of trousal fungicide with different SDC concentration, 30 millimolar, 40 millimolar, and 50 millimolar. Also we get the complete suppression. The last one is the mix sodium folate and sodium deoxyfolate as a surfactant from 30 to 50 millimolar. So we get the suppression. So this result from the correlation coefficient of linear regression between log POW and log K in MEKC with Bellsouth as surfactant, and we get the best condition with R square higher than 0.9 using the SDC as surfactant, sodium deoxyfolate. And then we apply this optimized method for the estimation of the log POW of 4 trousal fungicide, triadimenol, meclobutanil, pinpanazole, and propanazole. This result from the MEKC using SDC as Bellsouth. So this comparison of the log POW values of test trousal fungicide compounds, as can be seen in the table, triadimenol, the difference between log POW, A is the experimental log POW value from literature, and then C is the estimated log POW value from the RPS Bellsy method from the literature, 0.26, and then our proposed MEKC method lower than the literature. Very interesting for the log POW data. So this conclusion for this application MEKC for the chiral suppression and then the estimation of the log POW, the CD MEKC method for the suppression of 2 enantiomeric pairs of propanazole was successfully developed. The results show that the MKC method provides high expression efficiencies for the expression of the fibrinogen enantiomers compared with the other CDMKC method and then the SPLC method. And then, good limitabilities, limitation time, peak area and peak height were obtained ranging from 0.2% to 5.77%. And then, calculation curve are linear with the R-square higher than 0.9. And then, online persistent and chiral expression of selected terrestrial fungicide using CDMKC was successfully developed. And then the optimized sweeping CDMKC at pH 3 or acidic condition gave the best detection sensitivity and was successfully applied to the simultaneous expression of fenfluconazole, tebuconazole, and propiconazole in only one injection. This is the simultaneous expression. And then the LOD limit of detection for the three selected terrestrial fungicide range from 0.09 to 0.1 ppm, well below the limit set by the Codex Alimentarius Commission, CAC. Last one is this result provide lower LOD for the terrestrial fungicide compared to a previously study on the neutral expression for chiral terrestrial fungicide by SPLC. Other research study. This for the application of MKC for the SWP, this method was developed for the selected terrestrial fungicide, and then it was demonstrated that MKC STC sodium hexavalent method is applicable for low POW estimation of test compounds of terrestrial fungicide and better than a previous report on estimation by reverse-phase SPLC. And then last one is the optimized MKC is to be simple, rapid, and minimal sample per month compared to the conventional method. So this list of related publication from this study, the application of MKC, this rapid estimation of total water protection coefficient for the terrestrial fungicide by MKC with STC as surfactant and chromatographian, and then the online registration and chiral expression of propiconazole by CDMKC and ECA 2007. Also, this our achievement in exhibition, yeah, the list of awards. Firstly, in silver medal in the Innova Eureka Brasil 2007, then Best Innovation Award in Inatex 2007, and then the gold medal in the Inatex 2007. So this publication in Malaysian Journal of Plant Science, the Karla Index Focus. Index Focus. Then this one, the chromatography 2008. So this the JCA 2007. So this from Innova mereka. This the unforgettable moment. Yeah. So, so in the Inatex 2007. So this I would like to share about the maybe secret recipe, but our innovation. So we can get the could get the maybe a good medal or and so on. So this our recipe is the smart chiral expression kit. So this the summary of the reagent used which actually can be identified as the smart chiral expression toxin kit, so we can to commercialize this kit. So this composition of the chiral selector, surfactant, modifier, this the condition. So this carbonate column, and this one the buffer mixed with STS and cyclodextrin. So this is the patent filed in the 2008, yeah, chiral expression of propiconazole and antiomer using MKC and the application to tebuconazole, hexaconazole, and fenfluconazole. So we apply also the CDMKC to other terrestrial fungicide, hexaconazole. So this is the novelty of work. So this work at the novel expression of two antiomeric pairs of propiconazole and three other chiral terrestrial fungicides, namely tebuconazole, hexaconazole, and fenfluconazole using smart chiral economical novel and expression solution kit. And then this feature of product, economical cheap expression solution, novel method for non-terrestrial fungicide expression, and then able to produce faster and faster time compared with the SPLC technique, and then better bigger solution. It is also at the publication in Journal of Pharmaceutical Science, SINA, And then there's also other publication in ectoparesis, and then the expression of the ciproconazole, voriconazole, and itraconazole. Also this other trazol, hexaconazole, benconazole, and clomipramine. So it is content only one calcentor, so we get the two peak for each other. And then this 10 peaks were observed and well spreaded using the CDNKC for ciproconazole, voriconazole, and itraconazole. And then this one, the online precursors and chiral expression of hexaconazole, benconazole, and meclobutanil, published in different journal. So this one, the CDNKC for natrocytal of hexaconazole, benconazole, and meclobutanil. So this GSS only chiral expression, but the chromatography is the online demonstration. So we continue the study on the chiral expression and then apply the online representative technique to the CDNKC method. And this one, the other application on the stacking and sweeping in CDNKC. So this our publication on the GPTA, yeah, on the chiral expression of iconazole, is the azole drugs, using also MEKC with hydrosolubile gamma secretase. So maybe we can use this MEKC or CDNKC technique to other drugs or other pesticide maybe, and then we can optimize the condition. So this our book in 2010 for the chiral trazol fungicide expression, published by Lambert Academic Publishing. Also this other publication, Chirality 2012, on the chiral expression of the glyphosate. So this one, maybe this result from the other CMOS or MEKC, maybe I can skip it, in terms of the micronasal nitrate in pharmaceutical formulation using MEKC. So this micronasal, and then this result of micronasal using the NMR, SBLC, GC, SPTLC, and then this the methodology of the study, yeah. And then this MEKC optimization. There are some parameters, temperatures, applied voltage, wavelength, buffer concentration, pH and buffer concentration, SDS concentration as surfactant, and then concentration of butan 1-ol. This result from the optimization with different temperature, and then this different applied voltage, and then this different wavelength, different buffer concentration, this one the different buffer pH. This one the different SDS concentration. You can see this result 0.25% is the faster filtration time, yeah. And then largest peak area. This one the concentration of butan 1-ol, and this one the summary of the analytical performance of the optimized MEKC method for the iconazole determination. Concentration strength in 25 to 2000 ppm is the recent regression equation. R square higher than 0.9, LOD about 1.7 ppm, LOQ 5.7 ppm, this is the RSD. So this is the this is a real sample using MEKC. So this solvent, and B is the iconazole nitrate standard, and then last one is the clean sample containing iconazole nitrate. So this is the result obtained for iconazole nitrate in sample cream. Clean sample, sorry, using combination of SPN and MEKC. So we get the percentage for recovery on about the 92.5%. So the conclusion, CE method was successfully developed for the selected azole drugs, and then so this other condition, then this one, the condition of iconazole nitrate in pharmaceutical formulation sample or cream using SPN and MEKC was successfully developed by microemulsion containing this condition. And then continue to last presentation in the application of the MEKC, the simultaneous expression of three selected non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or NSAIDs by MEKC. This is the NSAIDs, yeah, the anti-inflammatory agent with analgesic and antipyretic properties. Its anti-inflammatory effects due to inhibition of both COX and COX2, which lead to the inhibition of the prostaglandin synthesis, and then the said agent of the aryl alkalonic acid classes. So this is the selected drugs, acyclovena, ketorolac, and sulindac. So this is the chemical structure, chemical formula, and other data for the selected drugs. This one the comparison method of all the drugs analysis, SPLC, GC, photometric methods, and spectrophotometric methods. And this one the capillary autoreis method for drug analysis using CZE, capillary zone electrophoresis, MEKC, MEKC, and CEC, capillary electron chromatography. And then for this study, the objective is the objectives are to optimize the MEKC condition for the expression of the selected MSI, and then to validate the optimized MEKC method. And this is the methodology, and then this preparation of the macroemulsion. Maybe you can see it. And then this MEKC optimization for the symphony expression of the MSI drugs. This buffer, pH, concentration, SDS, SCN, as organic modified, butanol all concentration, ethyl acetate concentration, temperature, wavelength, plane voltage, and injection time. So this result in discussion from the optimization of the MKC, the pH 9, the optimized pH, and then the 10 millimolar buffer concentration, and then 0.5% of the SDS, and then 6% of SCN. This one 6% SCN gave the highest peak high, and then the best resolution, yeah, and then fastest inhibition time. Also, butanol using 6.6%, and then the 6.6% butan 1-0 this speed, yeah, give the best solution, and then concentration of the ethyl acetate, so 0.8% ethyl acetate gives the fastest inhibition time, and then rapid analysis. Then this vision of the MEKC with different temperature, and the 25 degrees Celsius the best condition. Also this wavelength optimization, 200 nanometer, and then a phase voltage 30 kilovolt, fastest inhibition time and good flat number, and then the injection time, yeah, seven second, and then this result from the optimized MEKC is the calculation curve. And then this one the calculation data, concentration strength and in ppm, 50 to 200 ppm, R square higher than 0.9, and then this LOD and LQ. So this is the conclusion for this ongoing study. The MK system with 10 millimolar buffer and 0.5 SDS, 0.8% ethyl acetate, and 6.6% butanol, and 6% acetyl at temperature 25 degrees Celsius, applied voltage 30 kilovolt, and wavelength 200 nanometer, using the HDI injection, hydrophobic injection, for 7 seconds at 50 millibar, was able to spare 3 selected drugs with resolution higher than 3.7. Good resolution, high peak acid efficiencies, and blood number higher than 66,000, and short time less than 9 minutes. And then the method validation, the calculation curve of a fresh big area, again the consider of standard range, good repeatability, the mention time, big area, big high, and then the liquidity range from 15 to 200 ppm, calculation line board linear with the R square higher than 0.9 for all standards. So this our latest publication in chromatography for the comparison of HPLC and FEKC for myconazole interact using in pharmaceutical formulation in online first publication. So this my acknowledgement to Prof. Professor Dr. Marwan Ibrahim as my supervisor, also from Dr. Professor Muhammad Masin Sanagi. Thank you very much for supervise me on the PhD studies, and also from Professor Dr. Muhammad Nur Hassan and Professor Dr. Hassan Wai Abul Unain, our collaborator in Egypt, and then SESTEC members, my students, our student, BSM student, master student, PhD student also, and all members of SESTEC, thank you very much for your support. And then the Pusina Institute for Fundamental Science Studies, Department of Chemistry, Field of Science, UTM, MUHI, Higher Education, and MOSTI, and also my home institution, Universitas Jenderal Sudirman, or Jenderal Sudirman University. Nickname is the good student in Purwokerto, Jawa Tengah. So this, so our research collaboration, maybe we can continue this LOI between the Pusina and our university. So this, the representative of SESTEC member. So this my transformation from the this student, this postdoc, my matrix, this staff, okay, three steps in my career in UTM. So thank you very much for your attention. We love you there. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.